here we are.
And I got to go on Tiny Chat for a little bit. I entered a couple rooms, and I immediately started addressing the issue of terrorism. The difference between terrorism and peace. And just by bringing the subject up, it automatically triggered negative responses of terrorist attitudes. Bam, just like that. So what I did was I just identified the difference between being peaceful and being terrorist. And, you know, one of the guys said, "So what, are you calling us terrorists?" And I says, "Well, everybody is a loving person. It's just that we tend sometimes to do things that are as a terrorist would do, terrorist actions. But at heart, we're all peace and love. It's just that we've forgotten that we are actually that. So we just need to be reminded." And so the whole time when I was talking, you know, just maintaining a peaceful attitude, and I said, it really isn't no different from the United States, President of the United States entering this room and talking about the difference between peace and terrorism. It's not the difference, not anything any different. And, you know, we all have the capacity, you know, to represent presidential levels, because we are all kings. Now, some of us might not be there yet, but we have the potential. And we have the potential to gain wisdom, knowledge, and understanding so that we can rehabilitate ourselves or be rehabilitated. Like I said, all terrorists are going to be rehabilitated on the earth. All terrorist acts. You know, reason why people do terrorist acts is because of a lack of understanding. And that comes from not understanding where we came from and where we're going. Where we were, where we are, and where we're going. But I understood at any time they could have just kicked me out of the room. In fact, one of the guys was saying, "Hey, just give me the word so I can kick, and I'll kick them out." And but see, I entered the room and there was no one talking. No one was talking, so I decided to initiate some conversation. And as soon as I started talking, you know, I brought up the subjects of there's peace and there's terrorism. And automatically, boom, the terrorist attitude started showing up, speaking forth. And it's, remember, the terrorist attitude is one of finger pointing, and you can always tell by the tone of the voice. The language is derogatory, it's ridiculing, it's mocking, it's intimidating. These are all traits of terrorism. So at any time they could have kicked me out of the room, and so they eventually did. But I just kept on saying peace, 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 peace. And I put myself in that position on purpose, because I was actually doing my own therapy also. Because when you have acts of terrorism, or you're in the midst of acts of terrorism, those acts of terrorism are what they're doing at its root, are they're in trying to instill, or the intention is to instill fear into the peacemaker, or into the reality bringer. And so that's a good thing. That's a good thing for me because I got to feel those vibrations of fear come to me. And then how am I going to filter those through my body? I could have either became paralyzed and become quiet. I could have rose up in anger. I could have changed the subject. I could have left. But I chose to face those vibrations of fear that were being hurled at me through the various voices, which is just Mother Nature anyway when you think of it. It wasn't the people who were speaking to me like that. The people were just being used of Father Cause and Mother Nature as a test for me to see what I was going to do. And so what I did was just maintain my peace. And just filtered the vibrations of fear through my body. Not to let them affect me. But although the emotions did bring some fear into my body. But it's a training ground. It's a training ground to feel those emotions of fear. To face them head on. And to be able to operate within them, and then to bubble up the peace to bring those feelings of fear, to release them out so that they are non-existent anymore. See? Non-existence. That's the goal here on Earth. Is to get rid of all feelings of fear. Fear, anger, rage, confusion, pain. See? Till eventually everything's peaceful, loving. Because at heart, we're all one. We're all tied together. We're all one spirit, we're all one body, with many different characters, many different personal looks. We have different facial features, different facial structures. Peace. Remember, peace. Peacefulness. So, like I said, I entered the room, and no one was talking, so I decided to initiate some conversation. And I brought up the subject of, that's most near dear to my heart, and that's the subject of peace and terrorism. Peace and terrorism. Now, I didn't bring up terrorism until terrorism showed itself. I came into the room and I said, peace, peace, all is peace, well and peace. And then that automatically brought some negative tone in the voice. Da, da, da. And I immediately identified it. I said, ah, that's terrorism. And then the question came to me, what is terrorism? Da, da, da. And so I sat down within myself, and I treated that as just a thought floating by. And whenever you have a thought floating by, it's up to you when you're going to answer it or respond to it. So I says, terrorism. Terrorism can be recognized through the tone of voice. Seeing how it was a voice that was manifesting itself. After I initiated words of peace, And remember, when I initiated words of peace, out from the ears came an attitude in the tone of the voice, one of mocking and ridicule. So I maintained, said, peace, peace, peace. And that brought more ridicule, more stuff like, shut the fuck up. See, that's all terrorist tones of voice. It's terrorism. And this is the stuff that we're going to root out, the whole earth. And it will all be rehabilitated at the point of a gun. See? And the United States is leading the charge. And that's why we have bases in all the countries of the earth. Because we are the peaceful enforcement branch, the law enforcement branch, the master at arms of the planet. And that was initiated from the tribe of Judah in the Old Testament, where Father Kaz and Mother Nature christened a certain people, a certain person who had children. Written on the paper records called the Bible. You got Adam, Noah, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, King David, Solomon, and all the way down the line. It represents peace. The peacekeeping branch of the earth. And the peacekeeping branch, or the peacekeeping tribe of the earth, was put into place because of the kill or kill be world of the jungle, which is a world of terrorist acts. Terrorism. Now, like I say, when I entered the room and I said, peace, peace, peace. And as soon as terrorism rose its voice and said, ah, shut up, da, 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 I immediately said, ah, that's terrorism. Now, one of the guys did bring up the fact that he says, you entered the room and you were the one that brought up terrorism. And so now that I think about it, yeah, I was the one that identified the terrorism. I identified it. But I didn't initiate any terrorist acts. I didn't initiate any terrorist tones in my voice. Just by my showing up in the room, and there was no one talking, and I initiated conversation, and that brought about the response of, ah, shut up, ah, yeah, you suck, da da da. Those are all terrorist attitudes. And so then after that, I identified the attitude. I says, ah, that's a terrorist attitude. And so that fueled the terrorist attitude even more, with more people coming in and whatnot, with the unloving tone. Unloving tone is just another word for terrorist attitude. Terrorist acts, terrorist intentions. So I'm thinking, well, now, if I wouldn't have even brought up the word terrorists, maybe that would have been a more peaceful thing to do. If I just would have kept on saying, peace, Peace, brother. Peace. If my focus was on peace, peace, peace the whole time. Peace, brother. Peace. If I would just say peace when they're saying, shut up, da 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 da, shut up, shut up, shut up. Right? Because remember, this is a free earth. And the room is an open room for anybody to walk in. Now, it would just be the same thing as if they were out on the planet, just standing on the street corner, and I approached them and said, peace, brothers, peace, peace. And all of a sudden they start saying, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up. Well, if I was a high-level police officer undercover, standing right there, and they didn't know it. In fact, I am. And they started disturbing the peace by bringing in terrorist acts of, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up. Well, then I could have said some things like, well, if you continue with these unpeaceful remarks, then I'm going to have to arrest you. You see? And they would probably be something like, who the heck are you? And then I would have to say, well, I'm a peace officer undercover, and you're disturbing the peace. Would you please refrain and enter into a peaceful mode? Now, there's the other way of looking at it, too. Now, you got a group that's standing on a street corner, right? And you walk up and you say, peace. And if they say, shut up, shut up, shut up, that would be what's called an unwelcome to the group. So that would be their way of saying, you know, I don't like peace. I don't like you. I want you to leave. I don't like being around you. I don't like the fact that you've approached us, our group. I don't like the fact that you've said anything. And I especially don't like the fact that you said the word peace. We can just leave. Which I could have done in the room too. I could have just left. Because I could tell from certain people there that there was an unwelcomeness. Not necessarily the whole group as a whole. Just the ones that were talking. And there were only two or three that were talking. But you also got to keep in mind, all this that I'm doing is experimentation. Trying to find answers in life, to refine myself, to practice. And at the same time, they're allowed to practice their refinements too. So like I say, I could have left the room. I could have. And maybe that might have been the best thing to do. But, since that is the first time that I've done something like that, I have to rehash it through my mind and think about these things. See? But, I decided to stay there. because that's the route that I wanted to try. Until eventually they did kick me out. But if you're on the street corner, and you got a gang of people there on the street corner, you see, and you walk up to the gang, and you say, "Hey, peace," and they say, "War, terrorism," you know, or the attitude is, "Shut up, get out of here." You see? That's a terrorist act right there. So, with that being said, you know, what's the solution? What's the solution in commerce? Well, if we allow terrorist acts to continue on the planet, that's just the same as walking down the street and you see a banana peel on the street and you know that some elderly lady could be walking by at any time whose vision is not as clear as it was in her youth. And it's a potential for a public hazard and energy and injury. Well, what do you do with the banana peel? You remove it out of the path of peacefulness. You see? So it's just like if you have a cancer in your body. That's just another form of terrorism. Do you allow that cancer to stay in your body? Or do you remove it with your thoughts? Yes, you know the answer. You remove the cancer. No more cancer, people. No more disease. But if the cancer does not want to be removed, then we have to isolate it. We have to isolate it. And what we do is we rehabilitate the cells. See? We rehabilitate the cancer, or the cancerous cells. We rehabilitate them. See? Yeah. Nobody likes having cancer in their body. Nobody likes having their cells be cancerous. Cancer is just another word for terrorism. It's all the same thing. Everybody likes to feel healthy and joy and glad and peaceful. See what I'm saying? Yeah. So we do want to rehabilitate the cells because we want our whole body to be whole and healthy. And our body is just a smaller representation of the Earth, the planet, which is a larger body known as Mother Nature. And if Mother Nature has cancerous cells known as people that are exuding bad attitudes, which is just another word for terrorism. Anger, fear, ridicule, pointing of the finger, degradation, telling you to shut up. when all you're doing is bringing peacefulness into the situation. If there are cancerous gangs of people on the earth, in other words, terrorist gangs of people on the earth, then we need to help the terrorist gangs to find peace. And if they're not open for peace, then we need to round them up, isolate them, and rehabilitate them with love. Until they prove themselves to be rehabilitated. And we will know when they've been rehabilitated. It's easy to feel the vibrations of peace, and we can read their auras. You see? So, peace rules. Love rules. And all terrorists, all pirates, terrorists is just another word for pirating, or pirates, all terrorist acts, and those who are committing terrorist acts can be called terrorists, even though they're really not terrorists. They are really peaceful people, kings of potential, potentials of peace. But, you know, these are just minor details of words. We all pretty much get the big picture of what it all means anyway. So yeah, all pirates will be rehabilitated. All terrorist acts will be rehabilitated. Yeah, and very soon. This is all going to happen very soon. Peace.